Okay, four part two. In your first part, you have shown that this 2 cosecant 2 theta is this. So there is just one, like we don't need a 2 over here. What should I do about this 2, bacho? Can I write this as limit from pi by 6 to pi by 3, and I bring this 2 over here, half into cotangent theta plus tan theta. Now you people don't have learned how to integrate directly cotangent theta and tan theta, but you must remember that if you have f dash of x over f of x, that is ln f of x. So if you look at this separately, cotangent theta, can't I write it as cos theta over sine theta? Yes. So what will this be? Yes. That is ln sine theta. Look at this tan theta. Okay, tan theta. I will be writing this as sine theta over cos theta. What is derivative of cos theta? Minus. So we need to have a minus here. So this will be minus ln cos theta. Yes? If you guys allow me, I can write it as ln tan theta. Yes or no? Because if there is ln A minus ln B, that is ln A over B. So sine over cos will make it tan. It's half ln tan 60. Tan 60 is 1 over under root 3. Anna? Tan, yeah, it is under root 3, yeah. And tan 30 is 1 over under root 3. This becomes half ln 3. And you have to show it this.